see the time of the presentation, so I will begin. The term Urn-field culture applies primarily to the culture of the Central Europe and its immediate neighbors. In the Central Balkans, in the term Urn-field is used to designate the time when the practice of cremation in the late Bronze Age flat necropolis has become ubiquitous. That was already mentioned in previous presentations here. It is unjustified to claim that it is the cultural phenomenon known from the core territory which spread, yet usage of the term recognized the occurrence of the certain elements of that phenomenon here. The important point I would like to make are there are specific in the periodization and chronology of the Central Balkans. The Urn-field culture is Central Europe and its neighborhood is not a phenomenon identical to the Urn-field in the Central Balkans. They are, however, very close. In the Central Balkans, the custom of cremation predates the spread of the phenomenon, but then it only becomes widespread during this period. And inhumation is an established custom of the late Bronze Age. Information of burial practices collected to date has been subject of several syntheses, most focused on the narrow geographical area. You can see it on the slide that was colleagues before me that tried to make some conclusions about that custom. In the following presentation, we bring together information from the Central Balkans and the most recent analysis of the necropolises and Sandanski and Belay. These two necropolises are not used in detail in that presentation. I use it only as a vantage point to make some conclusions about Central Balkan area. You see that necropolis is marked on with red color. The presentation focuses on the region of the two large rivers, Morava and Vardar, with their tributaries. These rivers provide the bridge between the Danube and the Aegean, as there are almost no serious natural barriers along their courses. There are specifics in the periodization and chronology of the Central Balkans, already mentioned before me. There is no single periodization system, which results in certain confusions. Its lack is a consequence of efforts to utilize the Central European and Aegean chronological system for the Central Balkans. There is also regional periodization of the Bronze Age, in which the stage of interest to our presentation is called Late Bronze Age, Transitional Period, and Iron Age 1A. This sometimes leads to attribution of the certain cultures to cite directly termed periods. The beginning of the period under discussion is marked by widespread appearance of cremation in flat necropolises. Approximately from 14 till the 12th-11th century BC in the north, where the graves with cremated remains constitute the majority, metal finds have been parallels with Central European Urn-field period of Bronze D, Hallstatt A1 period. In the south, the finds could be directly synchronized with the Aegean chronology and the late Bronze Age periods of the Castanast, Assyrost and other North Aegean settlement mounds. Radiocarbon dates from the region are still being amassed and are difficult to match to the conventional dates. Conventional, I mean pottery dates that previous colleagues already mentioned. From the Belay necropolis by the Danube, which recorded more than 100 graves with cremated remains, there are 8 radiocarbon dates obtained from animal bones. 5 of those dates belong to the second phase of Belay and are synchronized to the finds discussed presently. Cremations in the Central Balkans. In the north of the Central Balkans are the necropolises with cultures Parsin, Gamzigrad and Verbicioara 3. with cremated remains placed in urns. Traditionally, those are attributed to the Bronze BC or 15th-14th century BC. Most distinctive of the period, but and best studied for the late Bronze Age of the Central Balkans, are the necropolises of the Burnica culture. On the slide, the finds of this culture are traditionally analyzed in the context of the Urn-field, the culture and the period. Concerning the Burnica culture, the date, its ceramic assemblage is analogous to the securely dated site by Sandanski on the slide, synchronized to the Castanas horizon 14-13 and Assyros phases 7-5. Specifics: the necropolises within the entire region manifest communalities, but also variations. In most instances, the cremation remains are placed in an urn of a relatively standardized shape. Less than half of the graves feature stone structures encasing the urns. The most typical example of an urn lid is the bowl. There are isolated examples of urns covered by a stone slab or by a slab and a bowl. As an exception, the cremated remains are placed upon the ground covered by a bowl. Only 20% of the graves produce any grave goods. As the urn and the lids are, in sense, burial gifts, additionally, additional wares are rare. Ceramics as a burial gifts is attested in approximately 8% of the graves. Metal is rare. Several pins, hair ornaments, tinkets made of thin bronze sheet cut to miniature arrow. The pins with conical head and the globule of the body are also restricted to the Central Balkans. These metals are found in approximately 17% of the graves. Weapons, spearheads, arrow and knives are only in few graves. Pottery, the urns typically with a spherical conical body and two or four handle jar, occasionally with relief button of the maximum diameter. Beside the rare two-handle bowl with white incrustation, most vessels are undecorated. Other burial practices that coexist in the area are necropolises with inhumation from the Central Balkans. They are synchronized to the necropolises with cremation, and they are attested in the west and the south area, but not in the north. The specifics: the necropolises in west area with inhumation will belong to two chronological groups, Bronze CD and Bronze D, Hallstatt A1 period, according to the ornament, to the orientation of the body and the type of the burial structure. Inhumation in hockey position, in burial pits, or extended on the back in pits with stone structures. In the earlier graves, those consist primarily of the bronze pins with flat heads and large open bracelets. To the later phase could be attributed a number of bronze finds, pins, as well as certain vessels from forms, canthers. Since bronze finds have been recorded in the central, similar bronze finds have been recorded in the Central Europe. There are also finds of weapons, a knife, swords with tongue-shaped handle, Mycenaean-type rapiers, open torques with incised geometric ornaments. Pottery is underrepresented. According to the finds, the closest contacts are to the carriers of the culture of the Glasinac complex. The use of stone structures, the presence of burial inventory of the bronze objects and weapons could be synchronized to the Aegean late Helladic III period, when Mycenaean influence on the Balkan rises. There are no known settlements of this society or no published settlements that be attributed to this society. The south of the region another one group with inhumation. The burial custom of that group is very standardized. Inhumation in hawker position with orientation dependent on the sex, carefully constructed boxes of hornstone slabs. The burial structures are reused repeatedly. The necropolises are flat, some with many graves. Inhumation in cist is well known from the necropolises of northern Greece, and the custom is carried out until the terminus of the Mycenaean period. The necropolises feature bronze items, bronze knives and swords, belts of conjoined miniature double axis pins. The pottery is local, handmade. It is monochrome with dark brown or black surface. The shapes include primarily deep bowl with two high ribbon handles, often with knobs between the handles. Canteroi with high handles, terminating in a look. Among the most representative finds are those of mud-painted ware, replica of North Greek imitation of the Mycenaean pottery style. The settlement of this culture is very well known, located in proximity with the necropolises. And my conclusions, my summary. During the late Bronze Age, cremation and inhumation coexist in the Central Balkans. In the West, there is evidence of biritualism within one necropolis. Possibly six examples of such necropolises exist. In the South, the two practices, the burnica type or the urn-field type cremation and the inhumation, occur in separate necropolises. In the North, only burnica type cremations are attested. So, burnica type necropolises are attested through the entire region, but in the West and the South, they coexist with other cultures. Cremation in flat necropolises with urns covered by walls fits with the urn-field phenomenon, and it's coeval with the development of the urn-field in Central Europe. The custom has its predecessor in the Central Balkans, preceding its emergence as the definite feature of the period of Central Europe, but becomes ubiquitous alongside the urn-field cultures, known from Central Europe. No information is available of the settlement of this site. In the necropolises with burnica type cremation are stone structures encasing the urns in all the micro regions. These are built chiefly in the southern regions. However, they are likely influenced from the neighboring cultures where such structures are very popular. Stone henges around groups of several urns are attested primarily in the north, where similar structures are found also during the previous period of Parachin and Gamzingrad cultures. And in the west, where for comparanda one should look to the sites of the Glasinac region. The custom of large flat necropolises with cremation is attested from the Central Balkans to Central Europe, which indicates influence from the cultures in this directionality. The pottery of the burnica culture is almost absent from the Egyptian west areas. The parallels are to the sites east to the Vardar Morava line, and thus suggest intensive contacts or affiliation also with the culture from these regions. Perhaps we are yet to register other necropolises with cremation in the region east of Central Balkans. That white spot here. Thank you very much.